If you're a fan of Jeff Bezos, then reading a few of his favorite books might improve you, uncover new perspectives, new ideas, and new ways to grow your business. Whether you like or dislike him, from the point of view, it's hard not to recognize his accomplishments. While sending Bezos an email is easy, getting him to reply and recommend a few books might not be. Also, books have played a crucial role in Jeff Bezos' life in more ways than one. The company that made Bezos a multi-billionaire initially started as an online book retailer. He has also spent his career changing the way books are published and sold, devouring many small bookstores in the process. But the Amazon founder and CEO also have a lasting love of reading, and it has played a crucial role in making him as a leader and the world most prosperous. Let's get to know about the 10 books that shaped the way Jeff Bezos thinks about success. If you are new here, please subscribe to this channel for a great video like this. Number 1. The Remains of the Day. By Kazuo Ishiguro. The Remains of the Day tells the story of Stevens, an English butler who had dedicated his life to the loyal service of Lord Darlington before the Second World War. Stevens later regretted over lost opportunities regarding his decades of selfless service to Lord Darlington. The book is one of the favorites of Jeff Bezos. He has recommended the book publicly, and it's also on Jeff's reading list, which Amazon employees are encouraged to read. The book helps people learn something about life and regrets. Some believe The Remains of the Day has affected the corporate culture of Amazon. The novel's theme of duty, sacrifice, and unrequited love has affected the way Bezos manages the company. Number 2. Built to Last. By Jim Collins. In Built to Last, Jim Collins and Jerry Porras focus on timeless success principles that can be learned from visionary companies like P&G, Marriott, and Walt Disney, whose success have lasted the test of time. Unlike individuals, organizations can transcend time and generations, they can be built to last. Although most of the companies studied were American corporations, the authors have since verified that the principles work across countries, cultures, and different organizations like corporations, NGOs, and many more. The findings debunked many myths about successful companies, and anyone can apply the insights, be it CEOs, managers, or entrepreneurs. Number 3. Creation. By Steve Grand. Creation is a blending aspect of philosophy, computer science, artificial intelligence, biology, and computer gaming. Grand attempts to define life, discuss the nature of the human soul, and demonstrate how it is possible to create entities that demand to be called both living and intelligent. A tall order indeed, and to tremendous effect, Grand draws heavily on his experience writing computer code. He is at his best describing the problems encountered and the solutions used to animate his virtual universe. While at first glance Grand's definitions of life might be off-putting, Grand explains his terms clearly and carefully, guiding the reader comfortably through various levels of discussion. He argues persuasively that life, both real and artificial, are emergent property, arising inevitably from the interactions of its parts. And as such, is something much more significant and qualitatively different from the sum of its pieces. This view leads Grand to assert that most scientists working in the field of artificial intelligence are taking the wrong track when they attempt to program intelligence into machines. Number 4. Good to Great. By Jim Collins. Good to Great is a book describing the characteristics of companies who leapt from being good companies to great companies. Though, Collins asserts that most companies fail to make the transition from good to great. This book briefed Amazon executives on many of the principles in this book before its publication. It explains how companies must confront the brutal facts of their business, discovering what they are uniquely good at, and master their flywheel, in which each part of the business reinforces and stimulates the other parts. Number 5. The Innovator's Dilemma. By Clayton Christensen. In this book, Christensen explains that companies grow by embracing disruptive innovation. Michael Bloomberg, founder and CEO of the eponymous company, once described the book as absolutely brilliant. An enormously powerful business book whose principles Amazon acted on, and that facilitated the creation of the Kindle and Amazon Web Services. Some companies are unwilling to adopt disruptive technology because it might separate customers and undermine their core business, but Christensen shows that ignoring potential disruption is even costlier. Number 6. Made in America. By Sam Walton. This book shines a light on the man behind the most prominent fortune ever amassed in business. It explains how he built Walmart into a billion-dollar empire with hard work, continuous learning, and an unrivaled resolve to make every single customer as happy as can be. Bezos learned the principles of discount retailing and core values of frugality and a bias for action and willingness to try a lot of things and make many mistakes. Number 7. Lean Thinking. By James Womack and Daniel Jones. This best-selling business classic by two internationally renowned management analysts describe a business system for the 21st century that supersedes the mass production system of Ford, the financial control system of Sloan, and the strategic approach of Welch and General Electric. It is based on the Toyota Lean model, which combines operational excellence with value-based strategies to produce steady growth through a wide range of economic conditions. Number 8. The Goal. By Eliyahu Goldratt. The Goal explains why optimizing activities that seem productive can be pointless. This classic management book, recommended by Jeff Bezos, has required reading for new Amazon managers to introduce the idea of identifying the bottleneck in a production system and restructuring the organization around it. It upends traditional obsessions with cost efficiency to focus on what matters. Number 9. Data-driven Marketing. By Mark Jeffery. Data-driven marketing explains how to use data-driven marketing to deliver a return on marketing investment. In any organization, in-depth discussion of the 15 key metrics every marketer should know. This book gives examples of how to apply return on marketing investment in small and large organizations. Number 10. The Black Swan. By Nassim Taleb. In this book, Taleb warns against the dangers of ignoring outliers and trusting experts. He gives advice on how to position oneself to take advantage of the unexpected. He creates a fictional narrative about an author's rise to literary stardom. He draws upon the work of some of his favorite thinkers in the fields of philosophy, mathematics, and psychology. Here you have it. 10 books that shaped the way Jeff Bezos thinks about success. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, watch more videos on our channel and subscribe. We love you.